Welcome to Rerun Repeat. We are your hosts, Ava Brooks and Molly Ruminer.
Today, our special guests are Bea Arujo and Talia Shanahan. Our show is To All the Boys I've Loved Before by Jenny Han.
Warning, there will be spoilers. We asked our students at our school has seen it and how many times.
Okay, yeah, I've just seen it 5 times.
Did you read the book?
No.
Okay, what about you?
I saw it like 3 times.
All right.
And I haven't read the book.
Yeah?
I saw it like once and I haven't read the book.
Okay.
I saw the movie like, I don't know, like 6 times, but I didn't read the book. I didn't even know there was a book.
Uh-oh.
I've never seen the movie or read the book.
Why? That's okay. So, have you seen the movie To All the Boys I Loved Before?
I have.
And how many times have you seen that movie?
I've only seen it once. I've seen it twice.
Okay. And then you haven't seen it. And then you have or haven't read the book?
I have not.
Okay. Well, thank you very much. So did you guys see the movie, To All the Boys I Loved Before?
No, I have not.
I have.
And how many times did you watch it?
I watched it once, but I want to watch it again.
Okay. And then how about reading the book?
I have not.
Yes, and I have not read the book.
And how many times did you see the movie?
Twice.
How about you?
I haven't read the book. I've seen the movie, and I've seen it like 3 times.
Very nice. That's pretty typical. How many times did you watch it?
Just once.
Oh, okay. Thanks. What about the book? Did you happen to read it?
Yeah.
And how many times?
Like 3.
And then did you read the book?
No.
Okay.
So I've seen the movie, but I have not read the book.
I haven't seen the movie or read the book.
I have seen the movie 4 times.
Did you read the book?
No.
Okay.
I've seen the movie 3 times.
I've seen the movie 3 times.
And did anyone read the book?
No.
Uh-oh. Did you see the movie?
Yeah, 3 times.
Very good. Did you guys see the movie To All the Boys I Loved Before?
Yes.
Yeah.
How many times have you seen it?
Once.
Twice.
Like 5 times.
Yep. Did you? Nope. Okay, you're over here. How many times?
Like 5 times.
Oh, okay, over here?
Yeah.
And how many times?
Like 6.
Yep. And what would you? No?
Sort of.
You saw part, yeah. And what would you?
I saw the movie 3 times.
So did you guys see the movie To All the Boys I Loved Before?
Yes.
How many times?
Once.
Oh, interesting. Did you happen to read the book? How many times?
Twice.
Okay.
I saw the movie, I've seen it like 10 times.
Nice.
I saw the movie, but I've seen it once.
Okay.
I've seen the movie, but I've seen it twice.
So I was sleeping one day, and then my mom called me over, and she was like, hey, let's watch a movie. And I'm like, okay. And she just put that movie in, and we watched it together.
Thanks, Mom.
I watched it with my with one of my friends because we were having a sleepover and we hadn't seen each other in months. And we were like, let's stay up late and watch a movie. So we picked All the Boys I've Loved Before,
and
we both ended up sobbing. And at the end, she's like, oh my God, my children are finally together. Because she like was like, they need to end up together. If they don't actually love each other, I'm going to be upset.
Yeah. That's one of my favorite Netflix movies.
Like, there's a bunch of other ones that have come out recently that are trying to basically be like another love story.
But like Kissing Booth.
Yeah, like
well,
the Kissing Booth.
Well, that came out before.
Yeah,
I know.
Yeah. or one of my favorites, Irreplaceable, and stuff like that. They're all like around the same exact like genre that Netflix is rooting for to be like their number one genre, basically, for their like new movies, basically. Mm-hmm. And but this one just stands out from the crowd as just something different.
Yep.
Yeah, it's original, unique, different. It's not like the classic love story. It's
like
not boy
because they have real problems. Like they have the problems that like we see. You know, they don't have like we're immediately perfect. They like they fight, they break up, they have like problems. So.
Sisters and people going away to college, and then dad not having like trying to find a girlfriend and
just like that real problems that like
that
we can relate to
everyday struggles
not makes just it a little like, bit we're perfect for each other
makes it a little bit more real.
You're actually problems.
They do things most high schoolers do, go to parties, hang out at home, watch movies.
I call the book realistic.
Very realistic.
Yes,
I agree.
What was your favorite part of the book?
Or movie.
My favorite part of the book was the end, because one of Lara Jean's crushes came with flowers and knocked on her door.
My favorite part would probably have to be when you see Kitty giving out the letters, because she just has this look on her face that says, I know what I'm doing and I'm proud of it.
Our favorite part was when Lara Jean told Peter that she liked him on the field.
And Peter told Lara Jean that he loved her.
We used the playlist from the back of the third book, Lara Jean's freshman year playlist, for her and Peter to go to college. What do you think of it?
It was really good. I really liked it.
Yeah. I didn't like it. I loved it.
Has anybody ever found something private that you wrote or recorded?
Yes. A couple years ago, I wrote in my journal, and my mom, she recently found it, and yeah.
When I was in first grade, I had this massive crush on this boy, so I drew him in my little notebook, and I wrote about him, and like how I was in love with him, and that he was the one, and stuff like that. And then recently, while me and my family were moving, my mom found that letter and she read it aloud to me, and I was like, oh no.
So we made contracts for our best friends, just like Lara Jean and Peter's contract.
Authors, best friends, or somebody we love.
What does yours say?
My letter is going to, of course, my boyfriend. yeah, I wrote a couple rules on it. Well, the first rule is to never lie. And if someone is going to lie, it has to be me, of course, though.
Talia, what did you write?
So I wrote my letter to Sarah Gray, the author of Kim Reaper. It says, Dear Sarah Gray, you have a way with words and pictures. Your comics and art are spectacular. You realistically created two lesbians without stereotyping, and it was amazing. You're really helping the LGBTQ plus community. I can't wait for Vampire Island. Love, Talia Lee.
What did you say?
I said, you always have to make me smile, and you always have to make me laugh. You always have to give me good advice. You always have to watch the sad movies with me. You have to read with me. You have to text me. You have to tell me everything. You have to tell me the tea. You always have to be my friend. You never have to leave my side.
I said, we stay friends forever, we never go behind each other's back, we always tell the truth, we need to take embarrassing photos wherever we go so we remember the moments, we must be okay with everything, you must be okay with everything I love and love it with me, and most important, always love each other and always tell each other about everybody that we like.
Or if I had to write a letter to my favorite author, I would write, I've read your books for a couple years, and I love your books, and I want you to write more books.
I'd say just to feel like, thanks for writing this and inspiring me.
That's awesome.
I would probably say something along the lines of, I appreciate like what you've done and how much effort you've put in.
Did you read all of the books?
I saw the first movie and read the first book.
I haven't yet read any of the books.
The idea of book two is that as soon as they're happy, another boy who got one of Lara Jean's letters comes, and then everything blows up.
We made cupcakes like Lara Jean and wore vintage dresses and used some of the recipes we think she would like. If you could make cupcakes like Lara Jean, what kind would you make? And would you wear dresses or clothes like she would?
Here's the clip of us doing it.
Is that low?
Yeah. Okay.
Okay, now. Next pen.
Okay, next one.
Ooh, that one might be a little.
It turned out like pink.
Mm-hmm.
coloring our homemade frosting. Molly's doing a green, and I am doing pink. But this is my purple. I want it to be very pale and pretty, but I think I might have left some blue color on the bottom. So that's my frosting, and then I have this one. Molly, what color is your frosting?
Orange.
Just for a little more, and chocolate. So we're gonna add some chocolate.
Her.
Still have frosting on my hands from the cupcakes.
Yeah. We made some of the cupcakes look like symbols from the book. Like, there's one of the field at the end of the movie.
We took a chocolate cupcake, put green frosting on it to make it look like the lacrosse field at the end of the movie where Laura Jean told
and then we
that
had some that made it look like Laura Jean made them, so there were, like, white curls on it. There was gold and white frosting.
Talia made one that had a cat on it for Kitty, for Laura Jean's little sister.
One that looked like a letter.
And then one that looked like a letter.
I'm proud of that one. So.
What did you like or dislike about the movie?
What I liked about the movie was how, like, her relationship grew with, like, several people, but mainly one, of course. What I didn't like about the movie and the book was how, like, she wrote lots of letters to all the boys she's ever loved, and then a couple of them had their hopes up, but didn't get it.
I really liked a lot of different things about it, especially the ending, because I thought that the ending part was adorable. But, like, there were a few things that just bugged me. Like, in the beginning, they barely explained who was who or what was going on. Like, it took me, like, 20 minutes to realize, oh, the mom's dead. I thought that the mom was just, like, off on vacation or they had divorced until it was, like, I missed mom. And that just was, like, you couldn't have specified somehow that the mom died sooner. It just bugged me.
For me, I actually, like, really disliked the movie. I thought it was really bad compared to the book, and nothing was the same, nobody acted the same. They didn't give you much detail. In the book, there were so many more descriptive words and phrases on everybody, and the characters acted different. The actors were very good, and I do think they played their characters very well, but the movie could have been made better.
Yeah, the book had a lot more details.
Did you know the actor's followers on Instagram spiked from 100,000 to 5.5 million followers after the Netflix movie aired? Did you watch any YouTube videos that the actors have done? If so, what ones?
I watched the backstage, lots of the backstage videos. I found those really interesting to watch and funny. And I saw a couple posts that they posted on Instagram and stuff about the movie.
I haven't seen any of their videos, but one of my favorite YouTubers made a video recreating their Instagram post before I even knew that the movie was a thing. And then that was one of the things that got me to be like, oh, hey, I want to watch this movie.
Cool. Okay. So now we're going to do a quiz to see how well you know the book.
Our little bell is the gong for the quiz.
Okay. What TV show do Kitty and Laura Jean marathon together?
Golden Girls.
Correct. Talia gets a point.
Keep track of your points.
What's the name of the diner where Laura Jean and Peter hang out?
Is it the Country Diner?
Wrong.
Nope.
kind nobody gets.
What's Lara Jean's drink of choice?
Cherry. Cherry Coke.
Correct. What car does Peter drive?
The blue one.
Yes. Yes. How many rules do Lara Jean and Peter make about their friendship? Oh. Relationship, not friendship.
5.
Correct.
How does Lara Jean's family know something is wrong?
I don't even know.
She cleans her room?
Correct. What book is Lara reading in the first scene of the movie?
The Forbidden Kiss.
Yes. How many letters did Lara Jean write?
5.
In what grade did Lara Jean and Peter have their first kiss?
7.
What veggie does Lara Jean get in trouble for eating in the library?
Carrots.
Correct.
So obviously the winner is Talia.
So you get to pick one of these posters.
Which poster do you want to keep in your office?
That one? Okay.
That one.
Did you read any of the sequels? Or do you plan to?
Oh, I plan to. Because it's just, there's just so much more that they can add onto the story. Like, I want to know what happens after the book, because there's so much empty space, because now they're informing everybody about their relationship even more, and it's going to go farther from a fake relationship, and that really, really intrigues me.
The books are incredibly popular. We've had multiple copies checked out nonstop. The public library never has any available, and are always on hold. And the local stores have back-ordered copies and none in, so we put the sequel on display. If you liked To All the Boys I've Loved Before and the two other books following, here are some others you may like.
Is there anything else you want to add about the book or movie?
One of my main questions was, like, there was a sign on the bathroom that Lara Jean went into when she saw that everyone had found the letters in the movie. But then a boy walked in, and that always weirded me out, and I, like, could never understand, like, why was he allowed in the bathroom?
That was Lucas. He was looking for Lara Jean. He was one of the recipients of her letters.
Yes.
And he was confronting her about it, and he told her that he was gay and, like, that she understood.
Yeah, I remember.
He just wanted to clear it up because he felt uncomfortable. He gave the letter back to Lara Jean. That's why he was in the bathroom.
I understood that, but, like, it said girls' bathroom, so that's weird. How did they get that picture?
Well, that's an interesting story, actually. Long
okay. They, one day after shooting, just between sets and shoots, the two actors lied down and took a nap, and one of the cast members actually found them there and took a picture, and they didn't do it on purpose. They just fell asleep like that. And if you look closely enough in the movie, it's actually set as Lara Jean's phone screen for a little bit.
Like how Peter's is Lara Jean before they go into the party with her hair down. That's Lara Jean's lock screen.
If you could ask the author, the actors, what would you ask them? If you could ask them one question.
I'd want to ask the author what her inspiration for the entire book was. Like, is it based off of a life experience, or is it based off something else?
Like Talia said, I would probably ask them the same question. Because I want to know where she got the idea to write such a good story.
I'd probably ask all of the actors, how much, like, how fun was it, and did, like, what did you do to get into the character?
What was your favorite part?
Did you read the book to get into character, or, like, what did you do? Because they played it very well. What do you think of the potential to make the sequels into movies, or would you want to watch the sequels to the movies?
Yes, I would.
Okay. Yes, I also would, of course.
So you would like to see them, what do you think would happen in the sequels if they did make them into movies?
Or what would you want to see happen?
I would probably like to see a very good twist.
Like what specifically though? Would you like to see what happens with the boy at the end of the first
movie? Of course, that. That's like one of the main things I would like to see because, yeah, that was just a very interesting ending.
I would definitely want to learn more about Kitty and all of the side characters, like Lara Jean's best friend. Like, she really interested me, so I want to learn more about her and more about everyone in the books. Like, because there's so many interesting side characters that I just feel like didn't get enough screen time that I feel like maybe probably got more in the book.
Like Lucas and Chris.
Yes.
I think they should make a fourth book and that's when they're all older, either in college or even out of college, and show their lives and have them still be connected, like all the friends, like Chris and Lara Jean and Lucas, and still hang out together.
Yeah, that's what I want to see too. I want to see if they come out with a fourth book if she decides to do that.
They should.
Okay, well, that's all for today. We're your hosts, Molly and Ava.
Keep reading and ranting.